Hello everyone, my name is Prashant and the topic for today's video is to automate the stopping and starting the EC2 instance using Lambda. Okay, so if you go to my YouTube channel and check my previous video, I have created a two videos where I have explained how to do that, like the automate the process of stopping and starting the EC2 instance using Python Boto3 script. So this video is basically an extension of that video, and in today's video I'm going to use the same script, but this time we are going to automate the process using AWS Lambda as well as the CloudWatch rule. Okay, so with automation I mean the script, this Boto3 script is going to run at a predefined interval. So let's say I want to automate this whole process, like this script will run just once a day, or if I want to stop my instances regularly after every 1 hour. So like the last time I have mentioned that the main idea behind that is to save our AWS bill cost. Okay, and this script is basically for the development environment where we want to stop all of our development environment, let's say after office hours, let's say after 5 PM, and then bring up all those instances at around 9 AM in the morning, and that is during the weekdays. So let me reiterate again, the main idea behind that is to save our billing cost, AWS billing cost. So this video is going to be a two-part series. So in the first part we are going to perform all these activities using AWS console. And in the second part, we are going to automate this entire process using the Terraform. Okay. So the technology which we are going to use is AWS Lambda. Okay. So what we are going to do, we are going to configure something called CloudWatch rules, where we have defined, let's say just for hypothetically 1 hour. So this CloudWatch rule, you can think of it like a cron job. So when the 1 hour clock is triggered, let's say it's 8:54 right now. So when 9:54 is going to happen, this CloudWatch rules is going to trigger. It is going to trigger our Lambda function. Okay. And the Lambda function is going to stop my EC2 instances. Okay. So now we have understand what we are going to do. Let's take a moment to explain what exactly is this AWS Lambda. Okay, so in the simplest terms, it is a serverless technology. Now, what do I mean by the serverless technology? Okay, so let's say I'm running a startup and I have some code which I need to run, right? So I have some code which I need to run, and to run that code, I need a server. It can be of any server, like it will run, let's say Amazon Linux or CentOS or Ubuntu, any of the operating system. Okay. So when I'm going to run this server, I need to manage it, right? I need to take care of it. Like this server should be up and running all the time, up and running. I need to patch this server at the regular interval. So rather than me as a developer focusing on managing this server, let AWS take care of managing this server part. So AWS will going to manage the server part, and what my role will be is to just to focus on the code. So I am just going to focus on the code, and all this infrastructure heavy lifting, like to make sure that server is up and running, to make sure it is patched regularly. In case if the demand increases, it will take care of automatically updating all the servers, or how many servers need to run behind my load balancer. I mean, just to give you an idea. So all these heavy lifting, all this infrastructure work will be taken care of by the AWS, and I should only be focused on writing this code. So as in this case, I don't need to manage a server, and that's why this technology is called serverless technology, or in some case you will heard a word called FAS, which is function as a code. So like the main idea behind it, because I am just focusing on managing this code part. That's why it is a function as a code, and you will see with the help, I am going to show you with the help of an example why we are saying it as a function as a code. Okay, so enough talking. The main idea which you need to remember is we are going to configure a CloudWatch rule which is going to trigger this lambda, and then that lambda is going to stop my EC2 instance. Okay, so now let's go to my lambda console. Okay, if you go to AWS console, let's search for lambda. Okay, and click on create function. Okay, here you have multiple options. Let's just focus on author from scratch. So I'm going to give this function name EC2 stop start. Or here, because I'm focusing just on stopping the instance, I will say EC2 stop. The runtime. I need to define in which language I have wrote this code. So in this case, I have written this code in Python using Boto3. So I will choose Python 3.7. Okay. Change the execution role, or I need to define an execution role. Okay. So this is important point to understand. So if you go here, okay. So lambda is going to trigger a function which is going to stop my EC2 instance, right? Or start my EC2 instance. Now, if you think of it, lambda is a service which will be hosted somewhere on the public side in AWS, right? And similarly, we have this EC2 instance, which is hosted somewhere on the public internet in AWS. So these are two different services. And in order for Lambda to give a permission to interact with EC2 instance, I need to define something called IAM policy or IAM role. Means IAM role will contain those policies. Okay, so this part, in order for my Lambda function to give permission to stop the EC2 instance, I need to define this IAM role. Okay, I think this should be clear. So I can create a new role with basic Lambda permission. So basically, Lambda give you this basic role. And what this basic role will do, when your Lambda function execute, it's going to write the logs in CloudWatch logs. Okay, that's the main role of this basic Lambda role, which is comes by default with Lambda. But in our case, we need to give them an extra permission, which include like EC2 stop and start, and basically few more other policies. Okay, so that's why we are going to write our own custom Lambda role or Lambda policies. So what we can do, we can open this rather than choosing all these options. I can choose this, go to IAM console. Okay, choose Lambda because we are going to perform this we are going to use Lambda for our script. Next permission. Okay, here click on create policy and open a new tab. JSON. Okay, and basically, let me copy paste this. I already have this policy in my GitHub repo. So, like I mentioned earlier, that basic Lambda execution role will have a permission to create a log group, log stream, and put log event. So basically, when this Lambda function trigger, it's going to write these logs to the CloudWatch logs. So this basically, for that, it need these kind of permission. For our use case, we need some extra permission, like for example, describing the instance, describing a region, starting and stopping the instance. So that's why I'm adding these extra policies, which is affect is allow and to any resource. Next tag. I will give it a name EC2 stop, because or start policy for lambda. Okay, I mean, and you will see that it has all these permissions here, right? So we have created this policy EC2 start stop policy for lambda. Okay, now go back to our role, because we need to attach this policy now to the role. I can do filter policy, customer manage, and I can choose this policy. So remember, don't be confused. Earlier we have created the policy, now we are creating a role out of this policy. And I still say EC2 stop start lambda role. Okay, so we have created the role now. So once again, what this role will do? This role will give permission to lambda to push the to give him a permission to stop and start EC2 instance. Okay, and the other thing like describe regions and all those things. Okay. So now go back to the AWS console, okay, and use an existing role, and out of this drop down bar, choose the new role, the one which we have created right now, and create a function. Okay, so our lambda function is created. Now click on this lambda function.py. Okay, remove this boilerplate syntax, and now we are going. I'm going to copy paste the code that I have created earlier. This place. So this guy. Okay. So basically the only change which I have done in this code, let me increase the font size, is that I have added this lambda handler. Okay, and it is going to accept two arguments, and this is also a boilerplate syntax for lambda: event and the context. Okay, I am going to discuss about this later, but basically what this will do is lambda is basically an event based, and event means when how this lambda function is going to trigger. So in this case, the lambda function is going to trigger by this CloudWatch tool. But there may be a cases where you can trigger a lambda function in some other ways. So let's say I am creating a code where I need to enable this VPC flow log. Okay, so VPC flow log, I need to enable it for the certain VPC. Okay, and let's say my team member, he's creating this VPC, but he's forget to enable this VPC log. So what I can do, I can create a lambda function which will enable the VPC flow log. Okay, enable the VPC log flow log, and this is going to enable our VPC flow log based on the event. And the event is whenever I am going to create a VPC, that is going to trigger an event. And that event is going to enable the VPC flow log. So that is why it is event driven. Okay, it will wait for some event to happen and then it is going to react. Okay, the second part is context. The context is when this lambda function is going to execute, it should have, like, for example, it has some kind of an ID, and that ID is going to be used, for example, if we are going to find it, if my lambda function is not working as expected, I can trace it out. So that is the context. Or for example, how much time in this lambda function is taking to execute. So all those I'm going to be taken into account in the context part. But for this lambda function, because this is a really simple lambda function, we don't need this. But to define our lambda function, we need to use this. Define lambda handler, event and context. Okay. And this is basically the entry point of your lambda function. Now, I have already explained this code in these two videos, but let me quickly go over it. So for the first part, I'm going to collect the region. So there may be a possibility that your developers has spin up the EC2 instances in different region. So that's why I need to collect the regions. Okay. Once I got the region, and remember that I am defining here as a BOTO3 resource, okay? And BOTO3 resource does not provide me any functionality to describe a region. So that's why I'm using a meta to collect the regions, okay? Please check my earlier video regarding BOTO3 if you want to understand what is this meta and what is this resource. Once we got all the regions, I will iterate over the EC2 instances, whatever the EC2 instances present in different region. And then I'm going to filter those instances based on if their status is running. Okay. I'm using this print statement just so that these logs will be printed in my CloudWatch log. Okay. And finally, once I got the instances which is in running state, I will stop it. Okay. So it's simple. And now in order to deploy this code, I just need to click on the deploy. Okay, so the code is now deployed. One thing you might need to do is, like, in case if you have a lot of EC2 instances running. So let me go to my EC2 console. And here you see I only have one EC2 instance running. But in case if you have a large number of EC2 instances running, the by default the timeout for your Lambda function is 3 seconds. So you might need to increase this timeout from, let's say, 1 minute and 3 seconds. I mean, it completely depends upon your requirement, or you will say like the maximum you can increase it to 15 minutes. Okay, so I have updated this value. Okay, now we are done with this part. We have created our Lambda function. We already have our EC2 instance up and running. The next part is to define the CloudWatch rules. Okay. So to do that, let's go to our CloudWatch console. Okay. Click on rules, create rules. And here you can define rules by two ways. One is event pattern. Event pattern I already discussed right now here in the, for example, for as a part of the VPC flow log example. But in this case, I am going to define it based on the schedule. And schedule I can define like 5 minute. Like, for example, I want to stop all the EC2 instances every 5 minutes, or I can even drill it down to, like, for example, 1 minute, or I can do hours or days, one per day, or I can define my own cron expression. Okay. So in cron, you can define, for example, the minutes, the hours, the day of the month. So let's say I want to stop my EC2 instances every day at around 6 p.m. Okay. So you can define a cron expression like that. And if you can see, this is how you can define. First field is a minute. Okay. The second field is an hour. So day of the month, month, day of the week, and year. So it will be like, so first field is minute. So let's say I want to stop it at 6 p.m. Okay. So first field is 6:00, or I can define asterisk. Okay. Or zero. Sorry. 16 is 18, because 12 plus 6 is 18. Then the next field is day of the month, month, every month, and day of the week. You can define it like this. I am going to define it like Monday to Friday. Okay. And then year, any year. So my cron expression will look like this. Just remember one point. This cron expression that you're going to define will have this event in the form of UTC. It is going to trigger in the UTC time zone. So make sure you are going to convert it. For example, my time zone is PST. So convert this UTC to PST, or PST to UTC, so that your job will be triggered at the right moment. Okay. So if I use this, okay. So this is going to trigger 18 at UTC. So please make sure that you are going to do that conversion, that PTC, PST to UTC, or whatever will be your time zone. Okay. So for this demo, I am going to define a fixed rate of 1 minute, which is a bad idea, but I just want to show you guys. And in the target field, I'm going to add the lambda function, okay, which we have just defined here, easy to stop. And then I will define EC2 stop. I'm going to define a rule. Okay, I'm defining it for stop. Similarly, you need to write one more function to start the instance. And just rather than using stop, you can just define start. Okay, so I will do that. Create rule. Okay, so now a rule is created. Okay, let's go back to our lambda function. Go to monitor. Okay, view CloudWatch logs. Okay, it will take some time for this to be created, so just wait for it. Okay, 1 hour. This is deployed. This is done. Okay. Just wait for 1 minute for this to be triggered out. Function. Hopefully I have chosen the right one, right? Easy to stop. This. Let me go back. Monitor. Okay, now it is created and you see that it iterate over all the regions, right? And then it is find out that in one region we have this EC2 instance running, which is CC850. So this is CC850. Let me refresh the screen. So as you can see, now it is in stop state. So our code works, or our whole automation works. So basically what we have done, we have defined, before that, let me add this. We have also done one, we have done one more thing. We have defined the IAM role. Okay. So basically this CloudWatch function, CloudWatch rule trigger, which invokes our Lambda function. And this Lambda function is going to stop our EC2 instances. And with Lambda, to trigger this EC2 instance stop, we need to define this IAM role or IAM policy. Okay. So this is the first part of the video where we have done all these things manually with the help of AWS console. In the next part, we are going to see how to automate this whole process using Terraform. And one more thing before I wrap up. So now AWS provides a service called AWS Instance Scheduler, which will automate this whole process. Okay, I haven't used this service, and the only thing which I feel is, like, for example, to use this service you need to deploy the AWS CloudFormation, and because I'm much more comfortable with Terraform, so that's why I haven't used this service. But please use this and let me know your feedback in the comment section. But this is all about how to automate this process manually or with the help of a console. And thanks for watching this video. If you have any question, please mention in the comment section. I will try my best to answer those questions. So thanks once again.